All right, round two, match three. And this is going to be an interesting one.
Well, you can say that again.
Johnny Gat, victorious in the first round against SBO. He now goes into this match against Hassan.
I spoke to Johnny Gat after the draw was made. He was adamant that he's saying, well, before the draw, he was adamant that he's going to get the Hassan. After the draw, he was happy and yet a little bit pissed off.
Gotta wonder what's going through Gat's mind right now.
I spoke to the New Saints and they're like,
well, they're going to be wondering how Gat's going to be feeling.
Not the New Saints, the Dead New Saints. I got to get that right. I'm thinking to myself right here, this match could sum up the entire tournament. Because if Hassan does get beaten here, the tournament becomes wide open.
Because everyone could be pretty wide open right now.
It's predicting that Hassan is favourite after losing the world title. But then again, you got the likes of Sebulba, Mewtwo facing off against each other. You got Arbiter facing Zinyak. Quite a few favourites have gone out of the tournament already. And two favourites not even competing. And those two favourites, well, one of them was the EXE Virus. The other was myself.
Well, anyway, here is Hassan.
Because I've had, well, yes, I've had quite bad luck in the first round.
Well, you didn't even get into the tournaments because you were out on injury.
True, but I've had bad luck in the past in the first round because one opponent I hate facing, I have faced twice in this tournament, and that happens to be a former winner in the EXE Virus.
This was back when he was in his Werehog form, wasn't it?
One in his Werehog form, and in the very first tournament, I got knocked out
by Sonic.
Yeah. In a hardcore rules match. I can tell you that.
Of course, the first time, but
I'll tell you what, everyone at that point, because this was right after MCAWW closed, Sonic was the odds-on favourite to win the tournament until Mewtwo came in.
Many people believe him, but when MCAWW closed down and CXWI formed, it was just going to be the MCAWW roster under a new name. But no, we completely revamped. Oh, big boots there by Hassan. And Hassan, out of the get-go.
You don't want to go in a brawl with Johnny Gat, because that's the worst thing you want to do. Because these two are absolute fighters here. This should be a hard-hitting match.
I'm certainly not going to question that. See the shots here now by Hassan. And boy, oh boy, Gat could be in trouble.
Chokeslam?
Upsy-daisy. Chokeslam.
I say chokeslam because Johnny Gat has the chance to counter, but he didn't.
Thrown to the outside there. Remember, this round is not T-Bone's rules, so you can use weapons in this one. However, oh man, there's still a time limit.
And we know what happened last time Hassan was in a time limit match. So this is why this is quite interesting. Hassan cannot do what he done last time. Oh god! For a moment I thought he was going to go through the table.
You thought he was going to blow the clock out.
No.
Not up on the outside though.
I would say your worst line ever.
That was an accidental line. Had it been deliberate, it would have been better. Through the table! Of course, it's Hassan. You know, if Hassan does try to blow the clock out, and I'm trying now to say it properly, if he does, he'll be eliminated. Oh!
Yeah, but does Hassan understand stuff? Normal rules.
I'm very certain he does. He may be big and he may be strong, but he's also very smart. I don't think he would have made it as a proper Dark Jedi if he wasn't smart.
Then again, you got to deal with some dumb rednecks at times. No offense. What
among the Jedi?
It's not a reference to Jedi's. It's a reference to something else. That is, right now, as I think of it, is irrelevant to this.
Oh, you mean being big, strong, and smart? can get to those smart rednecks.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I was talking to... I was just on a random chat.
Brass knucks! No way!
Brass knuckles!
It couldn't!
Oh, only a one count! Gat, they're using brass knucks! And now...
I'll tell you what would have been an interesting match. Gat versus Zinyak.
That was all there could be all possibility if we see that in the next round. Should Gat make it through Dasan? And should Zinyak defeat Arbiter? Gat drop!
No!
I'm moving out of the way. And now, look at Dasan! Hurricane Rana!
1, 2!
Holding for the cover! Kick out!
Oh! The force of that! Just absolutely.
And you see Gat still trying to fight. Oh, he gets clotheslined down. And now. Drop kick there.
Knocks the ref down.
Mm-hmm.
And what now, is Dasan thinking?
Dasan waiting. Clothesline!
He's not going to go for those clothesline combinations, is he? Or is
no,
he
he's
go-
not. Oh, boy.
Yep.
Gat's up! Gat's down! Tombstone! The Tombstone pile driver!
Oh, God!
Finishing it with a guillotine leg drop! He might not even be done there! Oh, wait, maybe he is.
Yep.
The cover up in here! No question about it.
I'm gonna go 3 for 3, but in all fairness, I said this match could go either way.
Dasan picks up the win and Dasan progresses to the next round!
Ooh, I might now just take back that statement I said.
When we look at this, Jack Stambridge, Matthew Harworth, Dasan.
I'm now going to take back what I said about Dasan. Dasan is still the odds-on favourite to win this tournament. And there's no question about it.
He certainly
after
proved
what
it.
You just saw
he
right
proved
here.
Proved it with this victory here. Look at this, a tombstone. And then he could have finished it there if he wanted. But knowing Dasan... He didn't want to finish it there. He wanted to bring the leg down.
And just pretty much ruined Gat's chances in this tournament. Johnny Gat is out. Dasan is through. Have mercy on your soul.
Well,
this
whoever's
going to
go up against him next is going to be worse.